Hello everyone, I am SHOHREH GHORBANI. I'm the founder and director of Project Control Academy, an academy that helps you enhance your knowledge and skills in project controls. In this training, I'm going to introduce you to the concept of earned schedule, so you know how you can use earned schedule metrics to assess and predict the schedule performance. In fact, earned schedule is a fairly new concept and is considered as an improvement to EVM scheduling metrics that you're going to learn in this training. Talking about earned value management, as you know, earned value management is a powerful tool for evaluating the schedule and cost performance of projects and also predicting the future cost and schedule results. But existing earned value schedule performance metrics, which are schedule performance index or SPI and schedule variance or SV, does not really do a good job with schedule performance evaluation and prediction. The reason, I believe, is twofold. One is earned value metrics are measured in units of currency, which is typically dollars, and that produces variances in dollars, which is useful from a budget regaining perspective, but not necessarily from the scheduling perspective. Let me show you what I mean here. This is an example of a project, which is obviously behind schedule because we are earning less than what we plan to earn. But here my purpose is showing you the EVM scheduling metrics. So one of those metrics is schedule variance and another is SPI. So schedule variance is basically the difference between earned value and planned value. And because each of those elements are in dollars, earned value is in dollar in currency and planned value is in currency as well, that's why the schedule variance, which is the amount of variance from your plan, is also going to be in terms of dollars, not units of time. And I believe you cannot really use cost or dollars to speak about time units or the amount of delays in terms of duration or even worse, the reason for the delay. And unfortunately, SPI and schedule variance are very often misinterpreted as a time-based indicator. For example, are we early or late and by how much? But in reality, SPI and schedule variance are not time-based indicators, but rather an indication of the physical status on how much of the work has been accomplished as compared to the planned work. That's one of the reasons why the EVM scheduling metrics are not used to estimate the project completion date, because as I said, the units are in measure of currency, not time. Another issue with the EVM scheduling metrics is that, you know, they fail toward the end of the project. The schedule indicators, you know, initially appear to establish a trend at the beginning of the project, but at some point around two-thirds into the project, the SPI and schedule variance begins to become really meaningless. Let me show you why. Here is an example of a same project I showed you earlier, which is behind schedule. So this is time now, and if we want to draw the schedule variance, so the schedule variance is negative because so far we've been behind. Now, we want to evaluate what's going to happen at the end of this project. Let's assume this project is completed, and is completed late according to what we see right now. Now, let me show you what's going to happen at the end of the project. So, at the end of the project, can you tell me what the SPI is going to be? Okay, let's examine the SPI formula, and the same thing would be applied for the schedule variance formula, the same, because they have the same element, earned value and planned value. So, let me play with SPI here. So, earned value, as you know, is physical percent complete multiplied by your budget at completion or by your approved budget over your planned value, right? So when I'm at the end of the project, what's going to happen here? What's going to be my physical progress completion? That's right, I'm at 100%. So at the end of the project, my SPI is going to be 100% of my budget, and plan value is going to be equal to my budget as well, because the plan value is the distribution of the budget over time. So at the end of the project, no matter what, my plan value should always be equal to my budget at completion. So based on this, what do you think the SPI is going to be? That's right, SPI is going to be 1 and scheduled variance is going to be 0, because at the end of the project, earned value is always equal to plan value. So regardless of, let me show you here again, if I want to draw this curve, at the end of the project, no matter how much we are delayed, SPI is going to be 1 and schedule variance is going to be 0. So now the question is, when we are approaching toward the two-thirds of the project, toward the end, we start seeing improvement in our SPI or schedule variance. They start showing improvement, as you can see here on this curve. So toward the end, we start seeing improvement. Now the question is, are these improvement real or they are false indications of the improvement? So, and that's really a question mark, because no matter what, at the end of the project, no matter how much early or late you are, SPI is going to be always 1 and schedule variance always 0, which shows basically a perfect unscheduled performance. But we know it's not right, because the schedule was finished months late. So this quirky behavior of schedule variance and schedule performance index, as I said, happens for every project approaching the finish line, no matter how early or late. So the question is, what can be done? How we can justify this behavior of schedule variance and SPI? Should we ignore the EVM scheduling metrics altogether? This is what many project managers do. They pay more attention to the cost metrics than they do for the schedule. But ignoring the EVM scheduling metrics doesn't solve the problem either. There are several good ways that you can enhance the reliability and accuracy of the EVM scheduling metrics. Here in this training, I'm going to only focus on one of those methods, which is, yes, earned schedule. Now, let me give you a bit of history about earned schedule so you better understand what it is and where it's coming from. Earned schedule is a new concept, kind of fairly new concept, that was initiated by Walt Lippke. I hope I'm pronouncing his name right. He initiated this concept back in 2003. Now, the good news is the earned schedule is now included as an appendix in PMI practice standard for earned value management, and it is considered as an extension to EVM practice. So as you can see, it has been released lately in 2011, so the age of earned schedule is not more than a decade from its initial conception. Although it has been around for almost a decade and has been, adopted globally, but this method remains unknown to many EVM practitioners. How about you? Is it new to you as well? Probably it is. That's why you're watching this video. I believe the earned schedule is a very simple concept, and it's not difficult to grasp. So I wish I knew that earlier so I could apply it in my own projects. But now I encourage you to do that. Hopefully after this training, you are interested to really learn more about earned schedule and start applying it in your own projects. And honestly, there is almost insignificant effort required to add and utilize the capabilities that are offered by earned schedule. So I really encourage you to use earned schedule metrics in your next EVM project and evaluate the outcomes and compare them to the traditional EVM scheduling metrics and see how they work. Now, ready to understand earned schedule? Awesome. Before I go to introduce you there and schedule and define this term for you, let me clarify the distinction between the earned schedule and earned value. You might question, okay, what's the difference between earned schedule and earned value? Are they the same thing? Well, the idea of the earned schedule is very similar to earned value. Actually, I want you to think of it similar when it comes to the metrics. But instead of using the cost or dollar value for measuring the schedule performance, the earned schedule uses time. Yeah. So rather than just looking at the schedule performance using the dollar value of work accomplished as compared with the plan, the earned schedule looks at when the work was supposed to be completed. So it focuses on the units of time and when really the work was supposed to be finished. So to help you better understand the concept of earned schedule, I would like to walk you through an example so you can grasp this concept very easily. Assume this project, kind of similar project as I shown before. Now, before I introduce the earned schedule, let me do some assessment based on the existing EVM scheduling metrics that we know to see how this project is doing. So here is the time now, which is end of the month of March, and our earned value, as you can see, it's $300, and our planned value is $500. So can you tell me what would be the schedule variance? Yes, the schedule variance is the difference between our earned and planned, which is minus 200, and the SPI would be 0.6. Now, our focus here is to examine the earned schedule and see how we can calculate it. These were the old metrics that you all know about. So now to measure earned schedule, we need to determine when the work was supposed to be earned. In other words, at what point in time was the current earned value should have been occurred? Let me repeat that again. We want to know at what point in time was the current earned value should have been occurred. So this is determined by crossing a line, a horizontal line, from the current cumulative earned value to the planned value curve, and the intersection of this line with the planned value curve projects that to the timeline gives us what? Yes, the earned schedule. So as you can see in our example, the earned schedule is what? Yes, it's 2 months. Therefore, earned schedule is the point in time when the current earned value was to be accomplished. It is the point at which the project plan value is supposed to be equal to the current earned value. So that was one of the first terms that you needed to know, earned schedule. There are other terminologies that you need to be familiar with. One of those is actual time. An actual time is the number of periods executed since the time the project started. So basically the time now, where we are now, the amount of duration or the periods, how many periods we are in. So can you tell me what is the actual time in our sample project? That's right. We are at the end of March. So we are 3 months into our project or three periods. Again, these periods doesn't need to be months. It can be weeks. It can be bi-weekly. So it's going to be the number of your periods, whatever that period is going to be. In our example, our periods are months, and that's why our time units are in terms of month as well. So our actual time in this example is 3 months. Another term that you need to know is the plan duration. And plan duration is the original duration of the project. So can you tell me what is our plan duration in this project? That's right, it's 6 months because we are planning to finish this project by end of June. So it's going to be 6 months. So far, so good? Awesome. So now with this, we have three key elements to assess the schedule status in units of time. And those three key elements that we need for earned schedule concept utilization is, first of all, earned schedule. Another one is actual time. And the final one is planned duration. So now to apply these metrics, we want to introduce new metrics, right? So similar to the traditional EVM metrics, we can generate new ones for schedule performance. Ready to know those? They are simple. So schedule variance in terms of time is the difference between your earned schedule and your actual time. And your SPI is earned schedule over actual time. And you can see that I have put kind of a T in there to distinguish between the traditional EVM metrics and earned schedule metrics. So we are not confusing between the two, because as you can see, the metrics are quite different. Now, going back to the example that we just went over, can you tell me what is the schedule variance in terms of time for our sample project? That's right. So our schedule variance is the difference between our schedule, our earned schedule and actual time, which is 2 months minus 3 months, which is minus 1 month. So it means that if we continue with the same performance, we are predicting that we are going to be 1 month behind the schedule. And how about SPI? What's your SPI in terms of time? Yes, it's ES over AT, so it's going to be 0.67. So just like our traditional schedule variance and SPI, a negative schedule variance and a less than one SPI shows what? Yes, a behind schedule status. But as you can see here, the behind schedule status is shown in units of time rather than units of currency. So in this example, we are 1 month behind, and the schedule performance index shows that for every hour that work on the job, we were only 0.67 hour, or around 40 minutes, productive in accomplishing the work that we planned to do. Now let me show you the calculations of the SPI and SV according to the dollar. So you can see the schedule variance is minus 200, and SPI is 0.6. So, but as you can see in the earned schedule concept, we are really measuring the schedule variance with units of time instead of dollars. Now, do you recall the issue that we faced with the SPI dollar and SV dollar at the end of the project? So do you think this issue is resolved with these new metrics of time unit SPI and time unit SV? Okay, let's examine that. So in the same project that we were working on, let's assume that we finished this project in the month of September, or month 9, and our total approved budget at the time of completion is $1 million. Now, according to this information, I give you a few minutes to assess the earned schedule metrics, performance index in terms of time and schedule variance in terms of time. I want you to tell me how much those are and how much they are as compared to our traditional EVM metrics. I just give you a few seconds so that you can have some thinking around it before I show you the result. Go ahead and do those calculations. Okay, we are back. Now let's examine this project and let's see, let's compare basically these two different scheduling metrics. We are at the end of the project, so how much is our progress? Yes, 100%. So our earned value is equal to our budget at completion, which is 1 million. How about our plan value? How much is our plan value? Yes, it's the same, 1 million, because plan value at the end is equal to our budget at completion. So can you tell me what is our earned schedule at the end of the project? Yes, our earned schedule is supposed to be the same as our plan duration. We were supposed to earn this project, finish this project, accomplish this project by the end of month 6, by the end of month June. So that's why our earn schedule is 6 months. So at the end of the project, earn schedule is our planned duration. How about our actual time? How much is our actual time? That's right, our actual time is 9 months because we finished the project at the month of nine. So the number of periods from the beginning of the project to now is 9 months. Now, let's calculate those SV and SPI and see what this project, how this project is doing. So let's start with the traditional ones. So schedule variance in terms of dollar is the difference between earned value and plan value. But because these two figures are the same, so schedule variance is zero, right? How about SPI? That's right, it's going to be one. So what do you think the SPI and SV is going to be according to the earned schedule method? Okay, let's see. So schedule variance in terms of time is the difference between our earned schedule and actual time. So our earned schedule is 6 months, actual time is 9 months, therefore the difference is 3 months. And that's exactly right, because we were supposed to finish the project in the month of June, and now we finished it in the month of September. So the actual variance is 3 months. So that's great. How about our SPI in terms of time? So our SPI is earned schedule over actual time, so which is 0.67. which is bang on, because it shows that we really are not, we were not performing well. Our schedule performance index is really bad, and that's why we were 3 months behind in finishing the project. So as you can see, SPI is not one anymore at the end of the project. So as you can see, that really, this simple project gave you a very important observation. And that shows you that SPI time and schedule variance time indicators really remained very good indicators of project status, while the traditional SPI and schedule variance, we ended up at 1 and 0, regardless of having this project completed 3 months late. So as you can see, the use of earned schedule will really improve your understanding of the schedule status and can enhance the use of your schedule EVM scheduling metrics. And I have to tell you that in addition to the schedule performance index and schedule variance that I introduced here, there are similar terms and terminologies as similar to cost forecasting metrics, such as to complete schedule performance index, estimated time at completion, and variance at completion in terms of time, that I have not covered here because I didn't want to confuse you with so many formulas. My purpose here was mainly show you the concept of earned schedule so you know really what it is, so you grasp the concept. Formula is easy and it's the next step. And in fact, I didn't show you the formula for earned schedule either, because the example that I showed you was easy. As I projected the earned value over the plan value curve, it falls exactly on an exact month, end of February. So that's why in our example, earned schedule was only 2 months. But in reality, it might not happen. So this might be an example of a project when you project the EVM over the plan value, your earned schedule happens in between a month. Now the question is, this fraction of the month, how you're going to calculate that? I didn't cover that in this training, because again, I just wanted to show you the concept of earned schedule, but that's not a big deal. That's just a simple mathematical calculation that I'm going to cover in another video. So stay tuned for another video where I'm going to show you more you know, metrics and calculations and formula for the earned schedule concept. But I hope that this video at least cleared the concept of earned schedule for you, so you know exactly what it is and how you can use it. But the bottom line is really the use of earned schedule enhances the earned value management ability to reflect the schedule status information. And with the metrics that I'm going to show you in the next video, you will see that you can even predict the schedule completion to some extent. Again, nothing should replace your critical path analysis. And these metrics, even with the earned schedule, you cannot really only rely on those metrics. You always have to complement these metrics with your critical path analysis and near critical path analysis. So never really look at those metrics alone, no matter if you're using ERN schedule or the traditional EVM scheduling metrics to evaluate your schedule status. So these are very good indicators that are showing you something is going on in your project. So you have to go deep into your schedule and understand what's causing the issue. But the good thing about the ERN schedule, as you saw through these examples and through this session, really improves and enhances the accuracy of the EVM scheduling metrics, especially toward the end of the project. So I hope this training raised your curiosity in the use and application of the ERN schedule in your projects and provided you a new means to justify your misbehaving SPI dollar and schedule variance dollars toward the end of the project. I hope you can use this ERN schedule in your next ERN value project and see the impact of it. So if you have any question about this, please submit your question down below this video. I will go through as many as I can and answer your questions myself. And if you found this training valuable, if it added value to you, and if you found it helpful, please spread the news by liking it and by sharing this video with your connections. So until the next episode of Project Control Mastery, do your best in everything that you do, my friend, and make a difference. Hello, this is SHOHREH. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Make sure that you subscribe to this channel so you continue to get updates every time that I release new training for you. Simply hit the subscribe button and you will be all set. If you have ever wondered or wanted to learn how to become distinguished for your ability to control and lead projects to a successful completion, I'd like to give you something special that I'm sure you're going to love. I have developed a series of training videos on ERN value management absolutely for free. Yes, for free. If you have ever wondered what ERN value management is and how it can assist you in understanding the true status of your projects, make sure that you watch the EVM training series that I have put together for you. Just click on the link below this post or go to projectcontroltraining.com/EVM free training and then enter your name and email so I can email you the training video series. Thanks again for tuning in, everyone. Until next time that I see you, do your best in everything that you do and make a difference.